What up, fam? Welcome to my channel. Y'all know what time it is. Let's go ahead and get into it. Deep breath in through your nose, out through your mouth. Let's clear our energy together. Here we go. Mother God, Father God, Holy Spirit, ancestors, guardian angels, ascended masters, passed on loved ones. Thank you for rising us up out of our beds this morning. And thank you for connecting me with the amazing viewer on the other side of this video. Glory to the Most High, for we are nothing without you forever and ever. Amen. Spirit, I ask that you come through me, use me for true, clear, concise messages for the ultimate abundance, sustenance, healing, forgiveness, love, joy, and everything in between. Amen. Welcome. It's good to see y'all. Happy early New Year's. We're going to get into some messages here. I'm going to do a little bit of remote viewing. We're going to get some channelings. My energy's been off the charts. Like, I slept so good last night, and I'm hoping that you are as well, because I'm picking up on a lot of really heightened, all over the place energy the last few days as we've moved through this Cancer full moon. The last full moon in 2023, it was a doozy. And especially for those of you that have Cancer in your charts, y'all are crazy sometimes, and that's all I'm gonna say. Anyways, so much love to you. I've already gotten a few channelings. The first one that I was actually being shown, oddly enough, was an exhaust system on a car. I was actually seeing smoke coming from a vehicle. So I don't know if this means you need to go get your exhaust checked, or you may be having issues, or a relay delay of some type, but that really came through heavily. I just heard the name Amanda. I'm being shown a golden doodle. You may have a golden doodle. I don't know. That breed specifically just came through. You might hear Achilles in the background. He's been sleeping quite a bit and snoring. The little hibernating chihuahua that he is. I just heard red tag. Red tag? Red tagged? Then I hear red flag. So viewer, if you're connecting with my frequency in this channel, you've really seen something. And it's interesting, I said I heard red tag and then red flag. I feel like you've seen something in somebody that is truly, truly out of alignment, that was masked. And they did a very good job of hiding that from you. This is something they know about themselves that they've never even admitted to anybody else. And then I just heard backpedaling, and then I saw somebody treading water. Whoo, I got lightheaded on that one. Okay. Then I heard you're the only one. You're the one. You're the only one. I'm hearing that. I also just saw a fighter jet. These are so random. I don't know, y'all. I'm just telling you what I'm hearing, what I'm feeling, what I'm seeing. I'm smelling sage. I did not burn sage before I did this. I've been using Palo Santo. So you may be burning sage right now, or may need to go stock up on sage, something to that magnitude. You may have someone that you know named Sage or love that color. Wow. I just heard go to the mattresses. That's in reference to the movie The Godfather. Go to the mattresses. It means like go to war and business. So one of you may be really gearing up for something very heavy here. You may quite literally be working on something related to the wars going on currently in the globe. I don't know, but I heard go to the mattresses. You may need to be getting a new mattress, or have just purchased a new bed mattress, something to that effect. I just heard Santiago. That could be a name, but also I feel like it's a location, Santiago, or a code name even. I'm hearing code name for something. Okay. Sir, what other messages can I relay? Use me for the truest and highest good for the viewer watching this video. Anything else? I heard crystal effect. You may have just received crystals or are purchasing new crystals. There's something really heavy about meditating with crystals at this time. And if you don't really know a lot about crystals, I highly advise that you research that, because the proof is in the pudding with regards to crystalline frequency, okay? So I really would advise you to maybe purchase a crystal of some type. I have not heard that song in forever. These are all over the place. I heard down by the boardwalk, down by the sea, yeah. I'll be making my bed, baby, is where I'll be. One of you may live by the ocean or are going to the ocean, having good times by the ocean with somebody. I don't know. That's really coming through. Or someone's reminiscing. There's something here with that. I've got music playing at random. As always, spirit comes through us with frequencies and different messages using lyrics, tones, things of this nature. What song do we have playing currently? Randomly, I have The Police, Every Breath You Take. All right, let's go ahead and get into some messages. Spirit, what is the overall lesson we're going to be covering here? Anything in particular? Egyptian Oracle Gods deck. Whoa. Happy New Year. The number 25 may have relevance. That may be a birth date. That may be your age. That may be 2 and 5 is 7. The month of July may have relevance. I don't know. There's something here with this. Now, what I really want to point out is the cups. This is quite literally, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 11 cups. Uh-huh. Okay. 10 of cups in the traditional tarot deck is ultimate fulfillment in emotional fulfillment. Y'all are about to reach a new height in 2024 with these 11 cups. The 11th cup, 717 on the clock right when I said that. The 11th cup is your own fulfillment before the 10 of cups can come in. I know that's right. Ashe, where's my... Woo! Come on. All right. So we're looking at renewal here. Now, this is a renewal of a soul journey, renewal of yourself, of your own energy, renewal of a potential relationship or partnership, friendship, family relationships. I don't know, but that's really what's going to be covered here. Spirit really wanted to acknowledge that. So let's get it. What else do we have coming in, Spirit? I'm going to use this deck. I haven't used this deck in a while. I love this deck. It's a little teeny tiny deck and it fits better in my hands. All right. I had the best meeting today. I am so excited for it. I'm in such high frequency energy. I got lots of rest, eating really good, drinking lots of water. So I hope to share that energy with you. Hopefully that you're doing the same. Spirit, what messages can you relay to me? Thank you. Wow. So the truth, clarity is coming in for you on a matter that you have been very in your head about. This is moving quickly, very rapid energy. And this is something that was causing restriction in and of yourself in your mind frame here. I feel that something was blocked on purpose by the divine. You were not allowed to see this. And now you're about to receive this clarity, I say, over New Year's Eve weekend. I'm hearing that specifically. Now, time is fluid. So if you're seeing this after that holiday, that could be this upcoming weekend for you. Take it as it resonates. But I'm seeing we have 8-8 here as well. The year 1988 may have relevance. 8-8 is also Lion's Gate. So... there's a portal. Tell me more. What's this restriction? What's this swiftness and restriction we're moving out of? Princess of Swords in the reverse. You may have been dealing with a feminine air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius, that you are completely at odds with, and this energy is closing out. I feel like the energy of this person, whether or not that's their sign, but I really feel like it is, this person has been completely out of alignment, and maybe that's been what part of the restriction has been here. I don't know. I feel like there's something tied in with that. Or you, if you are a female, maybe you've been dealing with a daughter that has been out of alignment, that is one of those signs, or you yourself have just been having like really some complications with your communication, and not so much on the delivery, but it being understood. That's something else that's really coming through here. Tell me more, Spirit. What's coming in? Thank you. King of Cups. Now, Interesting. So it's like this blockage is being removed for whoever, or if this is a person, I don't feel this is you, viewer. Okay. But whoever this is, that this is being eliminated or taken out. Now we're able to get to the nitty gritty of the emotions and the depths of emotional intelligence here. It's finally able to, I'm hearing water flowing, very much so. Tell me more, what's coming in for the collective, please. So that's great. You're it's almost like, I'm actually being, it's interesting. Whoa, thank you, Spirit. I just got tapped on my shoulder with that. So I went for a hike a couple days ago, and I noticed there was a tree that was down in a perfect triangle where a beaver had quite literally taken this tree down for a dam. They build dams, right, for their homes, these types of things, on flowing water. I feel like this King of Cups energy is now the water's able to flow. The dam has been broken. Something has been removed. A blockage of some type has been removed. Okay, tell me more. Again, that could be that Cancer full moon energy. I love that for you. I love that for you. And there's the Princess of Wands coming in. Phoenix rising. Okay, this is very powerful, magnetic energy. This is your energy coming back from the dead, possibly quite literally, feeling like you had just energetically been shook, or there's someone who has really helped facilitate this process here. This could be a Leo, Sagittarius, Aries, female. Tell me more. What's coming in for the collective, please? This could be anybody as well. Someone who really inspired you to take action. So, yeah, this person had a lot of power, a lot of power with this vitality. Even that speaks to the Ace of Wands to me. This actually is the Ace of Wands here. And then we've got the Sagittarius sign down here. So I'm not surprised to see these two coming out together. Whoever this was that inspired you to take action was absolutely divinely guided to you. I love this energy for you, and it's perfect timing with the new year coming in and the judgments now being called because of that. So you may have quite literally been making a choice between two feminines. These could be two feminines. One was out of sync, one wasn't, or one was detoured, dealing with their own karma, while the other one was completely shifting out of your life. This could have been a karmic person. Again, it doesn't have to be romantic, but it could be, what do we have here? Grills featuring Paul Wall and Ali and Gip Nelly. Someone's getting their swagger back energetically. So I really I love that energy for you. Yep, there it is. There is a major cycle. I feel like, I'm sorry, this is really giddy energy, y'all. I feel like you, viewer, have felt like you have not had your personal power or your personal swagger, or you haven't felt sexy, or you haven't felt like energetic. There's something here with that. That energy's boom, it's coming back. And I'm telling you, whoever this person was, they somehow had influence over that. And that's why that cycle is closing out. This also speaks to renewal, rebirth, the egg with the snake. Like, it's so there. One of you may have been born in the year of the snake. I don't know. But I love that energy. Okay, let's switch decks. Thank you, Spirit. So there's the first set of messages. This is big. I'm loving it. This is, I love that these blockages are being removed for you, collective. You've been praying for this. You have truly been praying for it. Okay, Spirit, what else do we have coming in? I quite literally just felt, I heard it and then I smelled it. One of you may be reading a lot, like heavy hard copy books. Maybe you're studying for something, or you're just reading and taking some time during the holidays to like read a book, or you're doing some research. We've got Ace of Cups here. This is brand new love for yourself. Brand new love for yourself, more appreciation for who you are, what you are able to create. Again, the water is flowing. Filling your own cup up first is how you can fill other cups up. Okay, tell me more, Spirit. So I'm smelling books. So this is talking about knowledge, education. You may work in that sector. Yep, there's Seven of Pentacles. This is something you're wanting to work on in 2024. I feel like the more you educate yourself, or you build your knowledge base, and that could be anything from your spiritual knowledge to maybe your job sector knowledge. You want to learn more in your industry. Maybe you want to learn a new skill. But again, there's something here with books, and books also speak to history. It is quite a fact. History repeats itself. So there's something here with that, and you're not wanting to make history repeat itself. That's why you're educating yourself. There's Ten of Pentacles. I cannot make this up. It's like the more you educate yourself and you deep dive and you facilitate that learning and those new skills and these new energies, it's going to truly bring in your dreams. This is also foundational. We're in Capricorn season. Shout out to Cap. I will have a birthday reading coming for you soon. But also, Capricorn season is about new soul contracts in and of ourselves. Also, new job contracts. Also, getting your finances in order. Planning. Financial planning is huge. If you are not working with a financial advisor, believe me when I tell you, I feel like there are people in your own personal network that would help you for free. All right? Mm-hmm. I just heard confirmed. Thank you. So look at who's in your network, or maybe it's a trusted family member or friend that's really good with their finances. Ask them for help so that you can build a proper foundation in 2024 if you've been having financial issues. It's here for you. And that's just something you need to ask the universe about. I'm ready to skip this song. Okay, goodbye. What else do you have to tell us, Spirit? Double Trouble, Eric Clapton and Steve Winwood. Okay, so, oh, that's making me blush. I'm not gonna repeat what I just heard, but viewer, I feel like your sexual energy and obsession is super heightened right now. It's very, very heightened with something going on here that's been an illusion. It's been like you haven't been able to make sense of it, and I feel like that's about to change. To me, more, my nose is itching heavily on that. Thank you. Someone you've possibly been at odds with, or you've like not understood, or yeah, you've been making a decision on this person. I also feel like one of you is working for a Cancerian boss, and you are about to leave that situation. They are bad news for you. Okay, that. Thank you. My temple just itched so bad on that. That was confirmed. I am picking up. This is very specific here. This isn't going to resonate with everybody. If you have a boss that has Cancer as their one of their main signs, this person is like drama, straight drama. You've seen it repeatedly with other people. Other people may have warned you about this boss. Whoever this authoritative figure is, whoever it is, you are making a decision to leave that situation because you know you're not going to grow in 2024 if you stay here. And so if you're not familiar with the signs, this person could have a birthday between, let me think here. I think it's June 22nd through July 21st, give or take. That's really specific. Okay, tell me more, Spirit. That was a warning. I just heard shots fired. Shots fired. Okay, thank you. Whoever this person is, they are truly trying to undermine you in some fashion. Mark my words. I feel it. I see it. This also may be a... I don't know. There's a weird... Yeah. There's a weird energy with that if you've got someone like that. Or it's either a Cancers or a Pisces. It's like that type of energy. Maybe both. Maybe you work with two of those types of people. I don't know. But judgment's being called, and it ain't going to go in their favor. You're leaving. Yep, I just got scratched on my forehead. Thank you, Spirit. Okay, tell me more. What's coming in for the collective, please? 18:18 on the clock right when I looked up. Here's that passion coming in for yourself and your life. Taking control back. I also feel like if you've been really low on energy, that is about to reignite. It's going to help you get out of whatever funk you have been in. I also feel, especially if you're a feminine, you have masculine energy really wanting to penetrate. And I'm just going to leave it there. Heavily, heavily. The boomstick is here, loud and clear. Tell me more. What's coming in for the collective, please? I can't make it up. Here we go with your manifestations turning out in a very good way as we enter the new year. Again, renewal. It's like it's just a new zest and joy for life. It was a doozy this year, y'all. And believe me, it was horrible for almost every single person I know. Even if someone had like some good things happen in their life, like, oy. And it was a year for change. 2024, 2 + 2 + 4 = 8. It's an 8 year. Things are going to balance out. That's also the infinity sign. It's going to be a heavy year of miracles and blessings and abundance. Okay. So call that in. Write your manifestations down on paper. I beg you, because that's going to facilitate subconsciously what you're trying to call in for yourself as we go to this new year. Some people like vision boards. I mean, my God, you could do that in an AI app or something like that. Like, there's a lot of things to it. It's going to help you clear out this heartbreak energy in and of yourself. This is personal heartbreak. I also feel, Okay, this goes both ways. I just heard this and I got to call you out. So whoever it is, I feel like you've had potentially three different people from three different areas in your life really break your heart this year. Family, colleague, lover. Let me say it again. Family, colleague, lover broke your heart. That's the overall collective energy I'm picking up on. Now, there's two other things that I'm feeling with that. If you're a masculine, no offense, you broke three different women's hearts this year. Again, could have been family, colleague, lover. And if you're a feminine, you had three men break your heart. I don't know. There's like, I keep seeing the number 333 with that. But that's about to be healed. It's really, truly about to be healed, man. I can't make it up. That's who you are. That's your energy. Okay? Confirmed. And I'm telling you right now, I'm calling it right now. This is about to be one of the most powerful years for divine feminine energy. Mark my freaking words. Shay, I know. I know that's right. Okay. Bottom of the deck, six of cups. You got somebody from your past wanting to return and make things right with you. They want a new beginning. Okay, so there's that. This could even happen in Aries season, give or take, which is going to be in about 4 months. I feel like this person's wanting to make their way back to you slowly. Whether or not they come quick enough, I don't know. I feel like you got a lot of suitors after you. Okay, tell me more. What's coming in for my viewer? And I'm going to switch to the final deck. Yeah, look, your psychic abilities, your gifts, your intuition is massively heightening at this time, and especially with regards to how it's going to help your communication. I feel like if you've had blockages with your communication, it's going to be able to come together very nicely because you're going to have a higher sense of discernment, especially with your own personal power. Once that personal power increases, it's like, boom, now your intuition is there, now your communication is there heavily. Side note, I feel like this is a couple you might be friends with or family members you might be friends with. You might be watching a Piscean that is partnered up somehow with a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. There's something about this connection. Tell me, what is that? You're going to witness something. They've been very quiet and you felt something was off with this couple, or that's like their energy. Like one's really intuitive, very quite literally a potentially marked person. And this other person is really strong with their communication, but they're not an emotional person. There's something that they've gone silent on. They could have a Virgo child together. There's the moon. I'm telling you, there's an illusion about this. What is this? I just heard, uh-oh, SpaghettiO. What'd these two get themselves into? Ooh. You're going to hear about a couple. You know what it is, collective? This isn't going to be for everybody, but I feel like if it's an energy. You're going to hear about a couple that you really admired, that maybe you were friends with or family members with or something, colleagues with. I don't know. There's something here about this. One of them has stepped out and had a affair potentially with a Gemini. Oof, I hate that type of stuff. It's going to like break your heart when you hear this. Okay, that's separate. Tell me more, spirit. What else can I relay, please? You got a message coming in. Someone wants to partner with you and manifest this back. That was actually in the upright. I feel like this is going to happen during Aquarius season, potentially. Someone really feels very strongly connected to you. I feel like this is a past lifetime connection. Wish fulfillment. Can't make it up. Yep, there's that. Okay. You and this person could live at a distance from one another. But notice the world card was in the reverse. This ain't over. Whatever this is. I don't know. Take it as it resonates. Okay. Anything else, spirit? There's a lot. I could keep going for another hour. And also, I think I'm going to start doing live readings on Friday evenings. So if you would be interested in that, let me know, because I would love to maybe communicate with you one-on-one. If you had questions at that time, you could fire questions away during the live. I could answer questions right there for you. But I think I want to start doing that. So, completely random channeling. One of you has been cooking and left your burner on. on the stove or the gas is still on, even though the flame isn't. I don't know. I just picked that up on that heavily because I can literally smell gas and it ain't here. Okay, what song do we have? Drake, You Broke My Heart. My notepad called many bodies. Screenshots all picked. What's interesting is there's angels on the album cover. Whatever this broken heart was, Spirit was protecting this connection as well as you. Good news? Good news is coming your way. Yeah, I know that's right. Okay, you're about to receive some good news, folks. Good news is coming your way. Something beautiful is about to manifest. Feelings of elation like you're on a cloud. It's time to celebrate all the wonder and the beauty in your life. If that's not a great message to end on for New Year's, ringing in 2024, I don't know what else is, fam. So I'm gonna leave it there. I'm being told to cut it. And right when I'm looking up at the clock now, it's 5:55. Mark my words. So heavy changes coming in for you for the better. I hope this helped. If you'd like to schedule a private one-on-one, all the information will be in the box below. Feel free to schedule on Mystic Sense. I do video call, chat, and phone call over there. And if this is where we part ways, my darling dears, I hope that these messages helped. Take care. Stay safe. Stay up. Stay focused. Stay strong. Peace.